A critical question arises from the Skill India Report 2020 is, are students job ready? India is widely known for enjoying its demographic dividend, but almost half of India's current population is over 1.2 billion people are under the age of 26 years, and the median age of the country projected to be 29 years by 2020. So, almost stepping into 2021, we know that the average Indian age would be somewhere around 29 to 30. So, India is making for the youngest country in the world. However, to optimally leverage this remarkable demographic, the country needs to continuously find ways to keep its manpower skilled so as to meet the demand from its industries while also seizing global opportunities by supplying talent to the international job markets. As a step further in the direction of improving the skills of the youth, we have been conducting an annual assessment of students to understand the kind and level of skills they possess and what can be done to better equip them for upcoming job market trends. The VBOX National Employability Test Survey, which was conducted for the 7th consecutive time this year, has been instrumental in its approach as well as reach for bringing forth the reflection of a youth's talent and their proficiency to meet the industry needs. The VNET or VBOX National Employability Test Survey that captures the state of the talent supply side was conducted from July 2019 to November 2019 with more than 3 lakh students from varied educational backgrounds participating in the test. The VBOX National Employability Test is a scientifically drafted assessment that serves as a guide to assess the talent pool available and test their employability from the perspective of their readiness to join the industry. This test was taken online and was accessible from mobiles, tablets, computers, as well as laptops. We approached more than 3,500 educational institutes from 28 states and 9 union territories of the country, making this one of India's most notable employability tests conducted so far. Also, to bring to your notices, the last 3 years, we have seen the same amount of jobs being taken by the students. So almost to the tune of 46%, the students have shown that they are job ready. To open the VBOX National Employability Test Survey analysis for 2020, let us look at the results for overall employability of students. About 46% of students in this year's survey were found to be employable or ready to take up jobs, while the figures show a marginal decline from those of the previous year. The overall trend is still positive in comparison to the past 6 years' result. This can be attributed to the rising efforts in skill development by the government and academic institutions. However, there is still a lot to be done, covered on the ground, in order to make all students employable, and requires holistic and concentrated efforts from all stakeholders: the government, industry, academia, and students. So for past 6 years, the figures are 33% to 46% when it comes to 2014-2019 data. Management graduates are most employable, while engineers witness a dip in employability score. When analyzed from the perspective of most employable candidate as per the courses, MBA students clearly stood out in the race with 54% score. This new trend has whipped that of the last 2 years, where their employability consistently remained under 40%. Surprisingly, this year the score for BTech students have declined significantly. The net employability score for BTech was 49 as against 57 registered last year. The decline is reflected across all trades of engineering. MCA graduates have also witnessed a decline in employability by almost 18%. The decline in technical and computer related courses paints an upsetting picture for India, which is widely considered a hub of IT professionals. Moreover, the industry is fast moving towards the adoption of advanced technologies such as AI, data analytics, robotics, AR, VR, and automation, which is opening a plethora of new job opportunities in the market. The declining quality of resources would leave these opportunities unused and hit the productivity of the industry. So across the domain, if you see that the jobs have been almost increasing, the employability isn't, but the jobs are there, but the employability isn't. Engineering courses, almost all courses are witnessing good amount of employability. Now the city with the highest number of employability is again Maharashtra, followed by Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka. Telangana has emerged a real great opportunity for all the students, followed by Delhi. Delhi is dipping down, Rajasthan, West Bengal and Gujarat. Gujarat is somehow way distant far. Another aspect of India Skill Report 2020 is when there is this male is to female, almost both are equally occupied. They are given equal chances, and there is definitely a lot of employability seen, but due to lack of consistency shown from the weaker sex, because of the reason that they are not able to pull on for a longer version in corporates, there is an iteration rate more seen in the female than male. Also, extension of this study clearly says that there is an ambiguity in information overload acting as deterrence. Preparedness of students to decide career path is a big question, and that's the reason you have a lot of overlap. Majority of students feel they are well informed to make career choices. Almost 86% of students cite that they are well equipped with the information to make better career choices. This is mostly facilitated by the information they get from their educational institute and about 55% of educational sites. So skill training and internship, if you talk about, then there are various aspects like skill trainings, internship opportunities, interaction with the companies, career counseling, career fairs, internships, opportunities. I think what support is required, major ask from the student side, it ranges from 32% to 37% as you go. From what support do the student require as to make informed choices about career, to what support will they like to get from the educational institute, to what support will they like to get from educational institute to enable them to prepare themselves for an opportunity in the employment domain. So this is a gist of it. Support sought by students are mostly skills training and internship opportunities together, making over 65%, so that's a significant percentage. Educational institutes and skilling ecosystem is required. There are two major areas where students require help from educational institute and skilling ecosystem to enable them to make better career choices, while also equipping them with industry relevant skills and knowledge to ready them for a job market. Additionally, students have also laid importance upon the interaction with companies, which is deemed necessary to stay updated on the job requirement. All in all, students feel the necessity to connect with the industry to learn and explore their knowledge horizons. To further highlight the importance of industry connections, a great majority of students believe that apprenticeship of 3 to 12 months will improve their employability to a great extent. National Apprenticeship Scheme, NAPS 2015, is surprising, as the rest 40% do not have information. So only 60% of the data shows that students are aware, 40%, which is a significant percentage, where the students fail to know the awareness of NAPS and their advantage in upskilling and maybe getting job ready. Now this has resulted in many students missing out of the opportunity, thereby raising concerns over the outreach and marketing of the government initiative programs and information dissemination by educational institutes about internship opportunities. Internship and projects are going to play a very, very important role in all graduates. So National Apprenticeship Scheme, NAPS awareness should be more than what it is observed in the report. Now, candidates' preferences, if you see the WNET, the employability test VBOX survey, apart from assessing the students on their skills and support required to enhance their careers also extends to understand the preferences in terms of internship and work location and salary expectation. So majority of the students seek internship, which is very valid. Is Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu are the preferred state. Of course, Telangana is the most preferred it has now become, because the kind of internship offers it has to, you know, give overall in comparison to other states. The salary range is somewhere more than 55% of students would like to have salary above 2.6 lakhs per annum. Moving towards the end of the VBOX National Employability Test Survey, we have observed that overall employability has remained stagnant throughout the previous few years, which is approximately score of 45%. This signifies that there has been no substantial improvement in the skilling ecosystem in the country. It is important to realize that as and the world shifts towards a knowledge-oriented economy, businesses increasingly adopt new technologies and the government strives to make its industries and talent stronger. The skill development framework cannot remain too far behind. The supply side needs to focus on the new age skills development, and especially in tandem with the industry demands, lest it could cripple the entire demand supply outlook. Further, students need to build an attitude of learning and accepting challenges rather than just passing and getting degrees. To this view, the government needs to monitor the enforcement of all its initiative and operational efficiency of the training.